Greetings. I know I should not be surprised by any statement told for Islam, but some bold-faced, stupid lies just leave my head shaking side to side at the deception of the brainwashed. I've recently had a Mohammedan post just such a stupid lie. Prophet Isaiah did not speak of a virgin birth. He did refer to a birth by a young woman, Isaiah 7:15 through 16. Wow, I thought, he's actually done some Bible study. He knows what Isaiah said about the virgin birth, and he's going to try the modern translation gambit. You know, cherry-pick the one errant translation that says young woman instead of an actual virgin. But I also have one general rule. Never ever accept what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. Check it out. Look it up yourself. You never know what you will catch. So I looked up Isaiah 7:15 through 16. Isaiah 7:15, 16. He will eat curds and honey when he knows enough to reject the wrong and choose the right. But before the boy knows enough to reject the wrong and choose the right, the land of the two kings you dread will be laid waste. That's the NIV. Maybe the NIV just got it wrong. Isaiah 7:15 and 16. Butter and honey shall he eat, that he may know to refuse the evil and choose the good. But before the child shall know to refuse the evil and choose the good, the land that thou abhorrest shall be forsaken by both her kings. Nothing about a virgin birth in 7, 15, and 16. Perhaps he just got the reference wrong. Let's look at what he said again. Prophet Isaiah did not speak of a virgin birth. He did refer to a birth by a young woman in Isaiah 7, 15 through 16. So I looked it up. The virgin birth is actually in Isaiah 7, 14. Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel, meaning God with us. I know, this is probably one of those careless mistakes, because Islam has no regard and no care for the Word of God, not even bothering to check and know that the scripture reference is accurate, is no shocker. It is typical Islamic behavior. It is typical Islamic ignorance and disregard for the Word of God. So not knowing the actual chapter and verse is not such a big problem. But claiming Isaiah made no mention of the virgin birth, that's a puzzle, because Islam claims it also believes Jesus was born of a virgin, not just a young girl. Also means they believe it in agreement with what Christians believe about the virgin birth. And the prophet who revealed the virgin birth was Isaiah. So claiming Isaiah made no mention of the virgin birth, that's a puzzle. Because if Isaiah did not mention the virgin birth, there is no such prophecy. Read it again. Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. The disciples would have nothing to recite, like they did in Matthew 1:23. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. I can almost grant it is just stupid laziness that got the verse wrong. But even as I was perturbed by this further example of Mohammedism's hatred for God and His Word, I saw another proof that the Bible is the Word of God. When the disciples claim the Torah says, you can find it. And whenever Mohammed says, I am mentioned in the former scriptures, you can't. We can confirm what the disciples said. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son. And we can find the original. Isaiah 7:14. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son. The word of God has been preserved. That's the proof. But the lies of Muhammad, they are revealed as the lies they are. This is a challenge for every Muslim in the world. Muhammad claimed to recite a passage from the Word of God, which Jesus spoke that foretold of Ahmad. Surah 61:6. And remember, Jesus, the son of Mary, said, O children of Israel, I am the apostle of Allah to you, confirming the law before me, and giving glad tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name shall be Ahmad. Clearly, in Surah 61:6, Muhammad contrived a claim that he was recalling a story about a time when Jesus is alleged to have said something that made mention of someone named Ahmad. This is the challenge for every Muslim in the world. Produce your proof if you are honest. Produce book and chapter and verse where Jesus said these words. And when you cannot produce your proof, realize Muhammad lied. And if he lied about this, everything else he said, all the commands, obey Allah and Muhammad, follow Allah and Muhammad, submit to Allah and Muhammad, all the threats, in fact, the whole Quran, all lies. So produce your proof if you are honest. Produce book and chapter and verse where Jesus said these words. Like Matthew quotes Isaiah. And we can look at Matthew, and we can look at Isaiah, and we can see what's quoted. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord reveal to you that Muhammad lied, that his words cannot be confirmed, that his words were false. Amen.